20, 40, 60, 80, 100. In every second in the last 12 months, almost 20 trees were cut down in the Amazon. See, deforestation and degradation is a kind of a disaster for the only country in the world that is named after a tree. Brazil is the fifth largest greenhouse gas emitter in the planet, but different from the top four, the bulk of our emissions do not come from burning fossil fuels. It actually comes from the way we use the land. That's 75% of our emissions. And the majority of that results from forests being cut down. You see, tropical forests are like the lungs of the earth. You heard something like that before, right? When we cut them down, they essentially exhalate the carbon that have been stored for over many decades. And they no longer exist to absorb the carbon and to maintain the evapotranspiration that keeps the cooling system of the planet. In 2024, the countries with the largest areas of tropical forests, like Brazil, Peru, Congo, Indonesia, lost an area of forest the size of Rwanda. And this forest has been converted to pasture, croplands, urban areas, mining, and also suffering degradation from logging, increased droughts, and wildfires. So we need to fight this degradation. And in order to do so, we have to understand what's happening on the ground. So digital mapping can be a key role on that. Because maps have power. But only if you can understand really what's going on the ground. So global satellite technology allows us to see the world in the palm of our hands. But these are just images. In order to understand what's happening with the land use, you need to capture the context of what we are seeing so we can understand the transformations across the time, and then we can act. So take a look at this pair of images in the Amazon in 1985 and 2023. On the first one, we see a lot of this green, and on the second, more of this light pink. But what is going on? We don't really know. Now, look at this is the same piece of land, but now we have a map that shows that forest in green has been converted into pasture, which you see in yellow, or some croplands like soybean, sugarcane, which you see in these different shades of pink. You also see a kind of a blue color, which is a hydropower lake, and also some urban areas growing on red. Until very recently, a detailed map like that for an entire country like Brazil was almost impossible to make because it was too costly and too slow to produce. So back in 2015, we put together a group of experts in remote sensing, computer science, and land use to reinvent the way we produce and publish maps. We call it Mapiomas Network. And now we can produce 40 years of map in 6 months. We do it by creating a mosaic of all the existing satellite images that we have for every year since 1985. Then we apply machine learning algorithms that allow us to classify each pixel and make a layer for every land use class that we want to map, like forest, mangrove, cropland, and water. Then we put all those layers together and produce a time series with one integrated map for each year. Now we have this kind of time machine where you can see every pixel and see the history of those pixels of 30 by 30 meters that are 9.6 billion of them that makes up Brazil. So for example, on this blue dot there, you see like something that was a forest and then in 85, then in 95 was converted to pasture, then in 2005 was converted to soybean, and so on. So now we can see the history of everywhere in the country in any time on the last 4 decades. But how this could lead to change? Have you ever crossed the red light and received like a penalty by email showing the license plate of your car? No, because dead people don't violate the rule. Yeah, but that's me. Yeah, it's a clear evidence that I violate the rule and, you know, like I can't deny, right? Yeah, so something very similar can be done with deforestation using remote sensing. Every time there is a deforestation detected in Brazil, we use high-resolution satellite imagery to validate precisely when and where the deforestation have occurred. Then we cross this information with the land cover maps, the registry of the land properties, the catalog of protected areas, and even the authorizations for clear cut, so we can produce very detailed reports like this one. In 2018, all the environmental agencies in Brazil together produced less than 1,000 reports in 1 year. Last year, in Mapiomas, we produced 2,000 of those reports per week. Those reports have a level of granularity and precision that can literally be used on the court of law. So in fact, between 2019 and 2024, the actions from the environmental agencies in Brazil against illegal deforestation increased from 5 to 54% of all deforestation. It's also happening on finance. So in the last 2 years, the major banks in Brazil denied $1.5 billion on finance for 30,000 farms that have deforestation detected by Mapiomas. And though this money went to more sustainable operations. So this, together with several other actions, allows Brazil to decrease the amount of deforestation in the Amazon by 54% on the last 2 years. Right? And this, which save all of us of 500 million tons of CO2 emissions. So this goes much beyond deforestation. In fact, in the last year, over 600,000 users access our data and apply on hundreds of applications, like, for example, preventing tropical disease, regulating the use of water, assessing climate change impacts, designing soil conservation practices, and protecting indigenous land rights. And actually, there's a good example here. You know, illegal gold mining is a huge problem in the Amazon. It destroys the land, it pollutes the water, and poisons indigenous people. So back in 2023, the Brazilian government decided to take action to remove 30,000 gold miners from indigenous lands. And one of the key strategies to do so was to shut down the airstrips that were close to the mines in remote areas, so the miners could not take the gold out of the forest, so they have to leave. So in order to do so, you have to find out where are those airstrips, right? So in just 3 weeks, our team was able to find out and map almost 3,000 airstrips across the entire Amazon, which is an area the size of Europe. So as of today, the number of gold miners in indigenous lands have dropped 90%. So none of that will be possible if we're not applying a kind of a collaborative approach. So Mapiomas Network is a group of over 100 organizations working across South America and Indonesia. And now, with the support of that community, we aim to, through the Audacious Project, we aim to increase our reach to cover 70% of the world's tropical forests by 2030. We believe that this, the ability and the power to produce locally your maps for action should be present on every tropical country. And then we can exchange the sounds of destruction by the sounds of life.